Mulholland, who is a mechanical engineer with over 20 years' experience in heavy industry across mining, energy, oil, and gas. He currently leads the portfolio strategy and product management functions for Dassault Systèmes, natural resources software business.
Good morning. So as Danielle mentioned, my name is Andy Mulholland. I look after the product management function within Dassault Systèmes Geovia brand. We have 11 brands across the Dassault Systèmes business. And within Geovia, we predominantly look at or develop software for the mining industry and other natural resources industries as well. So the title of my presentation here today is Realistic Multiphysics Simulation for Off-Earth Mining. I'm going to focus mostly on Mars, as this is the more immediate ambition for humans to colonize, and in this case, mine. And there's quite a number of active projects around Mars as well. However, the principles equally apply to the Moon and also to asteroid mining. So firstly, just a quick introduction of who we are, who DS is. Dassault Systèmes is a global software company. We're based, headquartered in Paris, and we're born in the early 80s as a spin-off of Dassault Aviation. Some of you may be familiar with the CATIA software. CATIA was the original brand that was spun off to create Dassault Systèmes. I come from the Geovia brand. You see there on the far right-hand end. And our mission is to model and simulate the planet. Okay, so the idea of off-earth mining is very much of interest to us, even though most of our focus, all of our focus right now is mining here on Earth. Our purpose, the DS purpose here is to, in one simple statement, it sums up our values, our aspirations, and our determination to push the envelope of current thinking, create sustainable innovations capable of harmonising product, nature and life. So this is across the entire DS portfolio, not just Geovia. For this presentation, the fundamental hypothesis that I would like to make is that the journey to Mars, and in this case, or in this subject, the mining of Mars, is bigger than one country, one organisation or one private enterprise can handle alone. And for a successful mission to place a human on Mars and the subsequent habitation, exploitation and colonisation, there needs to be a global collaboration without boundaries across governments, academic institutions, private sector, not-for-profit organisations and even individual scientists and engineers. We need a collaborative business and engineering platform providing the ideation tools, the design tools, realistic multiphysics simulation tools, and program management tools capable of coordinating this global effort across these organisations. So I will give you some examples of realistic multiphysics simulations and talk about that in the context of journey to mining on Mars. And I'll talk to you about what Dassault Systèmes is doing and working on in this field in and around this engineering platform. Firstly, the journey to Mars. Let's look at some of the challenges before I get into some of the ideas and the concepts around this platform. Let's look at some of the challenges we face. Mars is a long way away. Even making the very slightest mistake in the design of a component or a system that you would send to Mars can mean mission failure. So whilst we may use the Moon, which is only 3 days' journey away, the Mars frontier is much, much further. And from a mining perspective, once we've formulated a mining plan for a region, and we've created the equipment, and we've sent the equipment to Mars, we're committed. So we cannot afford to get it wrong. Also, in terms of challenges, the Martian environment is also a challenge. gravity's a little over a third of Earth's. The atmosphere's close to a vacuum, and 95% carbon dioxide. And the solar and cosmic radiation, as Rob mentioned earlier, is quite elevated on Mars and also a problem. And let's not forget the dust as well. We saw in some of those presentations and Bob's presentation yesterday, the dust on some of the rovers on Mars. So all up, it's a very harsh environment. And the differences between Mars and Earth mean traditional mining techniques, such as blasting, flotation, smelting, these need to be either widely modified or replaced with brand new techniques. Some of the techniques, in fact, that we just heard from Jürgen. But mining is necessary. As we've seen it over the last 2 days, it's a necessary early challenge to solve if we're going to create a self-sustaining ISRU mission to Mars. Water's necessary for human use, it's necessary for creating propellant. It's also necessary for the minerals process as well. And the regolith makes good construction materials, as we've also heard, and rocket propellant. So here at DS, we believe the digital world extends and improves the real world. And there's some examples here from a terrestrial, from an Earth perspective, of some of the digital twins that we can create with our, what we call 3D experience platform. First of all, the digital twin of the car. The next one there you see on the right, the top right hand side, is a Frank Gehry architecture designed building in Paris called the Louis Vuitton Fondation. And this was designed using a CATIA generative design software. Design simulated, manufacture was simulated before anything was actually even started to be constructed. The one you see down the bottom here, and I'll talk about this a bit more, is called the Living Heart Project that we created, and is now a global collaboration between universities, university research organisations, individual clinicians, and government regulatory authorities, and the private sector. So I'll talk a little bit more about that in a minute. The next one in here is 3D Experience City. And this is a GIP-led project where we're currently creating a virtual twin of the city of Singapore, both above ground and below ground. And the last one there is the 3D Experience Mine. So this is also part of GIOVIA's portfolio, creating a digital twin of the mine. So the proposition that we make is, if we could create a digital twin of Mars or the Moon, could we simulate any process, system or machine inside that digital twin? We think the answer is yes. And here are some examples that you see of the sorts of microphysics simulation processes that we could simulate in a digital twin of Mars before you place someone or something on the surface of Mars. So, for example, the deployment and landing simulations could be done inside an engineering platform before you manufacture the equipment and send it to Mars. Vehicle or mining equipment behavior on Mars. And I've got a short video on this one. So this here is using our simulation software to simulate crash tests. So you no longer have to build a car and crash test the physical prototype over and over and over again. You can design it. You'll see here the difference between the physical and the simulated in that last you can refine the designs and simulate over and over again before you get the optimum mechanical design. Another example that I'll quickly show by video is, this is our 3D experience mine, or virtual mine experience. So it's a virtual reality. You're seeing a video of a virtual reality instance of an actual mine that you've scanned, rendered, and then and then turn into this virtual reality scenario for a 3D experience mind. So these are other sorts of things that you can do with virtual reality before you send someone or any equipment to Mars. And there's various other examples here in this slide of the sorts of simulation that you can do, mind planning scenario analysis, the Living Heart project, which I'll talk about in a minute, human body response to the Martian environment, geomechanical simulation is another example. Sommelier abacus is quite widely used in the mining industry to model rock mechanics in FEM. And various other examples of multi-physics simulation. So, how do we deliver this, or what are we doing at Dassault Systèmes to further this idea? So, what we have here is a Mars Ideas Lab or Innovation Lab project called Home at Mars, where we intend to create a digital experience twin of Mars, where you can design a piece of equipment or a system simulated in the actual physical environment, simulated physical environment of Mars, simulating gravity, the atmosphere, all of the conditions, environmental conditions on Mars, before you send anything to the planet. And on the left-hand side, you see the cross-boundary collaboration using our 3D experience platform to collaborate between government agencies, private enterprise, universities, research, not-for-profit agencies, and all the individual scientists and engineers who have also a part to play. Now, I will play a video shows what we have already done in this respect. So this here is our virtual twin of Mars. We've taken, this is a 3D visualization of the planet Mars. We've taken data from the Viking probe for the colors that you see. We've taken data from the Mars Global Explorer for the terrain. And we've created a physical digital twin of the planet Mars. We also have one for the Moon, which I can show you a little later as well. And you're able to visualize anywhere on the planet. And as we get access to new data, new terrain data, new geophysical data of Mars, we can load that into the system and create an update. And towards the end, you'll see here how we intend to be able to place a physical piece of infrastructure. So in this case, a habitat. If you wanted to see how that habitat would look on the surface of Mars, play forward over time and see the effects of temperature and radiation and other environmental factors on that habitat, or a rover, for example. If you wanted to simulate how a rover maneuvers through the terrain on Mars, then you could do so also within Okay, so let's come back to Earth. We're a mining software business. This is our vision for the digital transformation of mining, the mining industry here on planet Earth at the moment. The mining industry is coming out of a very, very deep, I wouldn't call it recession, but a very low period. And the mining companies are starting to look at digital transformation of the industry to create this next generation or next wave of innovation. And the industry is talking a lot about autonomous mining. It's one of the major initiatives that most mining companies who are looking at digital innovation are enacting. And our vision for the autonomous mining is to create what we call the 3D experience mine. And you see here at the heart of it is this digital experience twin, with a range of parametrically connected applications that support autonomous systems, all the way from exploration and geology through to mine production. Connected to the traditional mining applications, so these are the traditional desktop geological modelling tools that that we all use today, including GeoVis, Serpac, GEMS, Minix, MineShed. They're all GeoVis desktop mining applications that we have today. The mining Internet of Things is the connecting to the equipment. And in the case of Mars, this would be the rovers and the new mining equipment that we create to extract minerals and process minerals on Mars. And on the right-hand side, you see there this immersive 4D visualization. So this is, as you just saw before, the virtual twin of Mars. We have also the virtual twin of Earth, and being able to play forward a mine schedule in 4D. So over time, play forward the mine schedule as you see your mine being being exploited and the minerals being extracted. So so you might ask, this is a grand plan to create this engineering and business platform for collaboration across boundaries. The Living Heart Project is an example of where this is, where we have done this before. The Living Heart Project is a collaboration across 40 academic institutions, 32 private industry organisations, 10 individual clinicians, and two regulatory bodies in the US. All have come together to create a digital twin of a person's actual heart. So you can take a scan, CT scan of someone's actual heart, and visualize, go inside the heart to diagnose deformities and problems in a patient, and then experiment on solutions to that that specific problem. So this is the model that we would be looking at to create and bring together organisations for a collaborative approach to mining on Mars. At the centre of this is our 3D experience platform. I'm running out of time, so I might just quickly cover off this. So the 3D experience platform is a cloud business and engineering platform that has all of the modelling tools, simulation tools, virtual reality tools, program management tools, and the collaborative capabilities that are necessary for dealing with all of the organisations in a particular project. Lastly, you might be asking, have we done the same with the Moon? We have. We also have a digital twin of the Moon. So again, this was taken, the terrain and the colours were all taken from lunar probes, NASA lunar probes, open source data. And as the data becomes more more updated, as the data is updated, then we can also update the model. So I'll, in the interest of time, so lastly, where we're at right now, we're interested, we're soon to release the software that you just saw, the two digital twins of the Moon and Mars, and also the Earth obviously. The point we're at right now with Home at Mars, that the Home at Mars project is to engage with industry, government organisations, agencies, private sector organisations, individual engineers, to establish this community of parties that want to collaborate across these boundaries. So if you're interested, then come and see me, and we'll talk. Thank you very much.
Thank you so much, Andy. We have time for one quick question.
So Yeah, the latter. So our vision is to be able to simulate the physical effects of the Martian environment on those structures. Right now, what we can do is we can visualize the planet, which is what you saw in the video. We can place infrastructure or mechanical, you know, rovers and equipment on the planet. But over time, we'll be developing the multi-physics simulation aspects as well.
Have you got to the point where you're simulating the lower gravity in your simulations, like Mars or the Moon?
So the low gravity elements is another part of the environmental aspects that we intend to bring in. So like I've just mentioned, what we have now is the virtual twin of the visual virtual twin of the planet, and then the next phase is to be able to bring in the including in the digital twin, the physical characteristics and the environmental characteristics of the planet. And after that, you place a component, a piece of infrastructure on the planet, and you can simulate the effects on it. That's our vision.
Thank you very much.